Ashwell, a research scholar in Department of Management of the University of Haryana. First of all, when we discuss about the topic, it is based on my ampoule evaluation, which is varies from your ongoing conference. It is very different aspects from your ongoing seminar that is on sustainable agriculture. It is based on the globalization. And it is, as we know, globalization has various implications in every sector, like as human development. Globalization is basically a socio-economic term where people think locally, act globally. It refers to a strategy of economic development where border of the countries do not matter for the movement of the commodity, services, capital, finance, labor, technology, ideas, information. This strategy generates a process of increasing economic integration and growing interdependence between countries of the world economy. Indeed, it is not only associated with the phenomenon of spread and volume of cross-border economic transactions, but also with an organization of economic activity which straddles national boundary of the world. The process of globalization started on a much wider scale with the emergence of capitalism as a universal dominant system in the world. This generated a very powerful web in the 19th century and continued in the 20th century till the outbreak of First World War. This was the period when colonialism was at its peak and this study is based on the secondary data taken from various national and international published reports and published and unpublished work of individual scholars, articles, research papers, monograph lectures of different authors from various journals, books, newspapers, periodical magazines, worldwide data, unpaid data, etc. The data has been extracted from all the above sources and analyzed by using percentages, annual growth rate, combined annual growth rate, and another statistical tools, and has been presented by using table, graph, etc. This study is based mainly on 1990s onwards, that is called post-reform analysis. Globalization in India had favorable impact on the overall growth rate of the economy. The major improvement gave a lift to the India's growth rate in 1970, which was very low at 3%. And GDP growth rate in the country like Brazil, Indonesia, South Korea, and Mexico was then twice that of India. Through India, the average annual growth rate almost doubled, which was lower than Korea and Indonesia. The acceleration in GDP growth had helped in India's to improve the global position. Consequently, India's global positions have improved from 18th rank, 8th rank in 1991 to 4th rank in 2001 when GDP is calculated on purchasing power parity basis. As a result of balance of payment crisis in 1991, growth in GDP which was classed to 13% in 1991 to 1992 gained momentous thereafter in the next 5-year period, that is 1992 to 2001. The annual average growth rate in GDP achieved was 6.1%. However, in the 10th plan period as a whole, average annual growth rate achieved 7.8%. Besides, in the last 3 years of the 10th plan, that is 2005-2006, 2007-2008, growth rate in GDP rose to 9.5% and 9.6% and 9.3% respectively. circular tables.
These are not called open environment programs.
There are a lot of just confusing by myself.
This difference participation.
In my research paper, there is a lot of aspects which had got more impact of globalization, that is structural transformation, employment, agriculture sector, foreign trade, foreign exchange reserves, and there is a linkages between foreign exchange reserves and gross national income. Skip, please. This table shows that export and import positions since 1991 to 2013-14, it shows that the gap between import and export are increasing, as well as the value of that import and export increasing at the same time. The balance of the payment, balance of trade situation is also worst in 2011-12 and 12-13, which shows increasing at that trends. There is foreign investment. As we know, foreign direct investment includes foreign direct investment, portfolio investment. Both shows increasing trends. If we call it, analyze this table, before the WTO and after the WTO, and before the world economic crisis and after the world economic crisis, the trends between foreign direct investment is less before WTO, it is more after WTO. Same in between the pre and post WTO. It can be shown by the graph. The process of globalization is hamstrung, as there are misgivings. Some are genuine and some are imagined. Globalization has positive as well as negative impact on the Indian economy. On the positive side, if globalization has accelerated the growth of the GDP, by which now India is 12th largest economy in terms of exchange rate, that is in US dollars, and second fastest growing economy in the world, India's GDP has touched US 1.225, that is increasing nowadays, trillion dollars. India has made a remarkable progress in information technology services and knowledge process services. Due to globalization, not only GDP increases, but growth in the sectors of economy also changes. Earlier, the maximum contribution was by the primary sector in the GDP, which has now overtaken by the service sector in the devotion with maximum part of the GDP. On the negative side of globalization had adverse effect on growth of employment. All the three unemployment rates, namely unemployment, unusual status, weekly status, and daily status, based on the national sample survey, increased during the period of post-economic reform, where they had declined earlier, even the period of growth, showing jobless growth. Next, please. Indeed, globalization has also generated high inequality among the Indian peoples, where only few peoples who are exploiting the resources of the economy, and most of the proportion of national income is proposed by them. This type of unequal distribution of income leads to marginalization of some groups, causing large-scale unemployment and inequality, as also observes of consumerism and damage to the environment. If adopted without check, it can cause loss of countries' sovereignties. It is also assumed that free market system tends to become a source of economic and political corruptions. India's experience so far mixed. How far the country's nation building can take us is still under the interrogation mark. The last one. Since the independence, the share of unemployment was high in the agriculture, so there is a need to give special attention to the agriculture sector. New agro processing plants should be established at different places to boost agriculture growth. Due to globalization, the share of service sector in GDP is increasing, but in terms of employment generation, it is lagging behind. Therefore, such policy and rules should be adopted in the service sector that can generate employment. The policy of government of India should be able to push foreign direct investment into manufacturing industry, manufacturing sector and high technology areas through which the Indian economy can effectively be part of the globalization process worldwide. Thank you.
You are saying 1.25.
Yes,
that
sir.
Is very old figure.
Yes, sir.
Actually, yourself, when you are having work on this area, you should have like 1 billion is a big amount. You are giving us 1.25.
Now,
and 2.25.
Yes.
Why you are giving out figure?
This is based on my empty level.
Yeah.
This is
the best you can
update. Yeah, sir.
When you are presenting prior to 2008, you want to do it. Thank you.